Prentice Hub has had a great start to the season for the Fighting Irish, who are coming off a loss on Wednesday against Duke, and now they go up against the Boilermakers. The 45th all-time meeting between these two schools in the state of Indiana is underway, and Purdue will start with the basketball as you take a look at Notre Dame's starting five. Robbie, they're going with a little bit of a smaller lineup today.
Well, this is the lineup that in the Kentucky game, they were able to really make that run offensively. Here's Sasha Stefanovic, a little screening action off the baseline, and he comes flying off that pin down, getting it done from the three-point line.
And you take a look at Purdue's starting five as well. They've mixed things around a little bit, but Trevion Williams, because of how well he's played the last couple of games, back in the starting five. And there's Trey Wirtz, who knocks down a three, and we're tied up. Trey Wirtz became eligible just on Wednesday and already making an impact for the Fighting Irish.
Mike Bray is super high on Trey Wirtz, and this is going to be interesting. Purdue going big, and they're going to pound it inside, but Notre Dame, you have to think they can flip that matchup and get you from three.
There's Trevion Williams doing what he's been doing the last couple of games. He's been scoring at a great rate.
He gets to his right jump hook, and he keeps the game simple. He is highly effective, and right there does just that.
And now Dane Goodwin back out to Cormac Ryan. 12 seconds to shoot for the Fighting Irish. There's Ryan, a three try off target. The rebound to Leszewski. And Notre Dame able to save it. Three try again from Wirtz, and that one too strong. But look at Dane Goodwin to run it down.
Boy, Notre Dame just playing harder than Purdue right now. Getting after loose balls, getting on the offensive glass.
5-3, Purdue the lead over Notre Dame as we're just underway at the Crossroads Classic. There's Matt Painter, the head coach of the Boilermakers, who has had an outstanding career coaching at Purdue, trying to get just his second window against Notre Dame and what'll be the fifth try in this Crossroads Classic. And it's Notre Dame basketball out of the timeout, and Hub on the drive and kick. Here's Wirtz on the wing for three. Cashes in again.
Just big time ball movement by Notre Dame right there. And Purdue botches a switch. You're going to see Mason Gillis right on that play. Gets blown by Prentice Hub. Terrific ball movement. Trey Wirtz the beneficiary again.
Wirtz the transfer from Santa Clara. Mike Bray very instrumental in trying to make sure that all transfers were immediately eligible given the season that we're in dealing with COVID-19. And so Wirtz scored 9 points against Duke on Wednesday, already six in the first few minutes today. Trevion Williams, the hook shot good.
Look at the way he's taking his time. He is really assessing the floor. He's getting whatever he wants against Nate Leszewski right now.
There's Prentice Hub, kicks to Leszewski, a three try, and he gets it to go.
That's Trevion Williams, that's not his help. You know, you're guarding a guy like Nate Leszewski who can really shoot the basketball, shooting over 50% on the season. Trevion Williams helps out of that corner. There's no one that can help you. He has got to stay tight to the shooter.
And Williams, the bucket and a foul. So Trevion Williams continuing to establish himself underneath, already 6 points here early on. And the foul against Leszewski.
Well, you can see right here, these are how these two teams want to play. Notre Dame is getting it done from the perimeter while Purdue is pounding it inside. Honestly, it's going to be a battle to see who can break who can be more effective in their style of play today.
So Williams will go to the free throw line. Early on in the season too, Robbie, I would think that both teams are still trying to establish what they want to do. Neither one of these teams had big non-conference schedules, so maybe that becomes even more the case in terms of strategy.
Well, I think with Notre Dame, they didn't get to play a ton of games, but the people they did play, it was an absolute gauntlet. You see Ohio State, you end up seeing Kentucky, now you play Duke your first league game. They're very battle-tested.
Notre Dame with the missed three from Hub. And now Purdue back down the floor. There's a three from the top of the key. Sasha Stefanovic too strong. Wirtz grabs the rebound and fires out to Cormac Ryan. Hub on the drive against a double team, has it erased, but keeps. And now Ryan, the second chance, the floater misses. Eric Hunter Jr. down the lane, can't finish, and Williams there to grab the rebound. Leaves Stefanovic open for three.
Just a big-time find. Trevion Williams tipping that ball to himself, keeping it alive, and look who's trailing right into the play. Sasha Stefanovic, who is shooting a blistering 48% from three.
And Leshefsky's fouled on the way in.
Just a big-time effort on the offensive glass. Trevion Williams keeping it alive, and as good a time as any to let one fly. Sasha Stefanovic locked and loaded.
So Leshefsky will go to the free throw line. Just under 73% so far this season. 6'10 junior from Jupiter, Florida. Cannot connect on the first. Take a look at Mike Bray, longtime coach, of course, at Notre Dame. 21st season with this program, has had an incredible run. The longest tenure of any Notre Dame head coach. Right now is team 2-3 on the season, but they have played a gauntlet of a schedule, so not really indicative of the type of team he believes he has. Leshefsky clanks the second. Here's Stefanovic for Purdue. Aaron Wheeler into the game as well. In the corner, Hunter for three and got it.
Boy, Prentice Hub really was sucked in on that help side defense, trying to help on Zach Edey, provide bodies, and if he's gonna help like that, Purdue is gonna have opportunities. Eric Hunter was wide open in the corner.
Coming off a good game against Ohio State earlier this week, had 15 points on 6 of 11 shooting. And now in the corner, a three try off target from Nikola Jogo. And Purdue will run. Wheeler for three. Clangs that one off the back iron.
Aaron Wheeler just has not been able to find the stroke. He really contributed in other ways. But shooting the ball has been a struggle for him this season and last.
As a freshman, he shot almost 37% from three. Last year, just under 22%. So like you said, Robbie, that's one thing that Purdue certainly wants him to improve upon this year.
He's found other ways. He had 13 rebounds against Indiana State. He's done some good things on the defensive end of the floor, but he is capable of making shots. We saw it his freshman year.
Hunter for three from the wing. Splashes it through, and it's an 11-0 run for Purdue.
What a difference Eric Hunter makes in the lineup. Missed the first few games of the season with an injury, and just his aggressiveness and his maturity. Very comfortable in Banker's Life, an Indianapolis kid. You know this event means a ton to him.
And now Goodwin hoists for three, and Notre Dame needed that one.
Nate Goodwin has been on fire. He's now 8 of his last 13 from three, and it's another pretty good look. Notre Dame's gonna go small. They're gonna get looks from the perimeter.
Wheeler goes inside to the freshman, Zach Edey, who lays it in.
He just physically dominates his defenders, and Nate Leshefsky is so undersized. Great job by Zach Edey keeping that ball high and scoring it.
Zach Edey 7'4", so a matchup nightmare, and off the missed three, the long rebound pinballs to Stefanovic. Hunter stopped his dribble. Inside to Edey. Stop and pop for Brandon Newman. That one will not go. Rebound to Cormac Ryan. Ryan loses the ball, and Stefanovic knocks it to Wheeler. Wheeler for the paint, and a blocking foul against Notre Dame. Brings us to a timeout on the floor. Purdue with an 8-point lead. Eric Hunter knocking down the three for the Boilermakers, and then they go inside to the freshman, Edey. We'll have more on him coming up. Purdue with an 8-point advantage. USAA Insurance Agency is ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball, brought to you by USAA Insurance, Auto Renters, and Home Insurance. As we welcome you back here inside Bankers Life Fieldhouse alongside former Purdue star Robbie Hummel, I'm Jordan Burnfield. Thanks so much for joining us. Robbie, it's a 13-3 run for Purdue over the last 4 minutes and 4 seconds. The Boilermakers running here early and looking good.
They are, and I think if you're Notre Dame, you've gotten good looks. They need more from Cormac Ryan. You know, he has really struggled, and I think at times, you know, he's a guy that he can find his own shot. Against Ohio State, he was incredibly aggressive, 15 points in the first half, and this afternoon, 0-for-3 early, and then just an unforced turnover. You don't catch the pass, and all of a sudden it's off to the races for Purdue. Now Aaron Wheeler finds himself at the free throw line.
Aaron Wheeler at the line with his first point of the game, the junior from Stamford, Connecticut. And the Purdue Boilermakers getting points in the paint here early, which is one of the staples of this program. Even though Notre Dame has hit some threes, they trail by 10. Dane Goodwin comes around a curl and takes it at the top of the key. Gets into the paint, Don Stefanovic. Fadeaway jumper won't fall, and Wheeler grabs the rebound but fell and traveled.
That was great defense by Sasha Stefanovic. And he's guarding a guy in Dane Goodwin who is as crafty as anybody at scoring the ball. He can get to his pull-up, he can post you. And right there, Sasha Stefanovic was in his grill.
So now off the inbound, Trey Wirtz gets a three ball, but Edie there to grab the rebound.
A wide open look. Trey Wirtz came flying off that pin down to the corner. Really good out of bounds play and a good look for Notre Dame, but you don't get it to go down.
Stefanovic inside the alley-oop to Edie.
Boy, you have got to be connected to Zach Edie, and Juwan Durham just turns his head. Gets caught staring at the basketball for just a second too long. A great look. Terrific lob pass right to Zach Edie.
Can't stop that, can you?
But you just have to be aware. You know, Juwan Durham has to do his work early, and when you don't, you're asking to get dunked on.
Juwan Durham answers back with a baseline jumper.
That's really his strength. He can really shoot the basketball. Like Prentice Huff, terrific job. Just smothering Isaiah Thompson. Purdue can't get the ball in. But back to that alley-oop. It's a great pass from Sasha Stefanovic. You see Juwan Durham gets caught ball watching. And you do that, watch your head. Zach Edie goes up and hammers it.
Notre Dame made its first two-point basket of the game off of Durham's make. And now Dane Goodwin tries from the baseline. That won't fall. And knocked out of bounds by Durham. It'll be Purdue basketball. Brings us to a timeout on the floor here at the Crossroads Classic. Juwan Durham and the Fighting Irish trailing by 10. Purdue the lead with 11:58 to go here in this first half. And you saw just a couple of minutes ago what Purdue has, which is another seven-footer. But this guy, Zach Edie, has a very unique story. Grew up in Toronto, was not a basketball player, as we show you our hoop scoop. This is a kid who grew up in Toronto and, like many Canadian kids, wanted to be a hockey player, did not play basketball until he was 16, was focused on hockey and baseball as a pitcher. But coaches were pleading with him. Everyone was pleading with him. Dude, you're 7'4". You got to play basketball. Decided to do so about 3 years ago. And because of it, he is a little bit raw, but has taken so well to the sport. Did an extra year after high school at IMG Academy. Now finds himself as a center and making a big impact in the Big Ten Conference. And it's really pretty incredible because the things that he's had to learn over the last 3 years is cramming in all the basketball knowledge that many of these guys have been learning since they were four. You see, he was the tallest kid on his hockey team, like a Zdeno Chara out there, but now playing college basketball in America at the D1 level and in the Big Ten at Purdue, no less.
Well, he made the right decision because he's got a future, not just the collegiate level, but as a pro. Honestly, I think that for the majority of guys that play, it always amazes me for some of these big dudes that start playing and they've only been playing basketball for 3 years. I cannot fathom how bad I would be at basketball if I started playing at 16. It's just unbelievable the stories of these big guys that can do that and find a way and use their size to be great players.
Nice feed inside, and Cormac Ryan puts one on the board. Do you remember the first time you started playing basketball?
I mean, I had a little Tykes hoop in my parents' house from the time I was 2 and a half. It's what, when you're born in Indiana, that's just the way things are. You grow up playing this sport, and you go to your high school games, and you really get a good feel for how to play.
And now into the game for Purdue is Jaden Ivey. He misses that shot, and now a foul coming up. Jaden Ivey, the freshman from South Bend. He was thinking about this game all week, really all season he has been, because his mom, Nielle Ivey, is now the head women's basketball coach at Notre Dame. And of course, his dad was a football star there, Javen Hunter.
He's really talented, and I think that you can see his aggressiveness. He has that scorer's mentality, just like Etwan Moore did back in the mid-2000s. But, and Jaden Ivey is going to be aggressive. You saw it against Ohio State. He's going to look to score the ball.
Hub the miss on the three, and there's Ivey to grab the rebound.
Right now, Prentice Hub, Cormac Ryan, and Dane Goodwin are combined 2 for 11 from the field. Those guys are going to have to be the ones that really score the ball. They do the bulk of this scoring for Notre Dame, and they have not been in any sort of rhythm this afternoon.
And a whistle on Williams. Offensive foul against Travion Williams, his first personal, and it'll turn back to Notre Dame.
They're just going to get him for that off arm. Contact to Cormac Ryan's forehead.
Now Hub cross court to Ryan.
That's a great closeout by Ethan Morton. Cormac Ryan was really probing the defense there, and great help and recover, but better offense by Notre Dame. That ball moves, and Trey Wirtz gets a little bit of dribble penetration. And Cormac Ryan finally knocks down a three.
And now Notre Dame on a 7-0 run over the last 2.5 minutes. Get this game back within 5. Here's Hunter, knocks down the baseline jumper.
He has been on today. And that's a guy in Eric Hunter going against a really good guard in Prentice Hub. He's so comfortable getting to that step back. As a lefty, you step back to your right side. It's a really easy shot for left-handed players. Eric Hunter getting it done on offense this afternoon.
Wirtz here for Notre Dame with 10 to shoot. Ryan on the wing for three. That's off target, and the rebound Ivey. Ivey drives, stops from the elbow, knocks down the jumper.
Travion Williams flips that ball screen at the last second, and because of it, Jaden Ivey can get to his spot. The defense is playing drop coverage, gets to his spot and pulls up straight vertical. A really good looking pull-up jumper.
You got to feel like Jaden Ivey is so pumped to play today.
I think he might have come into the game almost foaming at the mouth to score. He is ready to go.
Three try off target for Durham. That's the first three try he's taken all season. And now Hunter stops and hands out Gillis for three. Good.
That was a beautiful action by Purdue and a big time delivery. Mason Gillis has now made 7 consecutive shots dating back to the last 3 games. Get a little roll from Travion Williams. Rising on the backside, Mason Gillis. Purdue's offense in total sync in Indianapolis.
Tomorrow, this should be a great top 20 battle in the Big Ten. Number 13, Illinois, squares off against number 19, Rutgers at the rack. This is the first time the Scarlet Knights have started a season with 5 double-digit wins since the 34-35 campaign. 1 Eastern, noon Central, ESPN2, and on the app. Robbie, you were telling me earlier, you think Illinois may be the best team, the most talented team in the Big Ten.
I think they are. I think when you look at their talent with Io DeSumo, Kobe Coburn, Trent Frazier, they have experience, they can defend you. Just really like what Illinois does on both ends of the floor. For Rutgers, man, you have to think, the Geo Baker injury, it certainly made it tough on them, and they ended up, they were 4-0 without him. But man, Those other guys really had to step up. Ron Harper Jr. looks like a first-team all-league type guy. You have Jacob Young, you have Montez Mathis. Those guys have to pick up the slack scoring the ball. And all of a sudden, Rutgers looks like a real contender in the Big Ten Conference.
Purdue certainly figures to be one as well. And right now they've got a 12-point lead as Jogo drives to the bucket and draws the foul.
Boy, a really good decision right there by Nikola Jogo. And you get some great ball movement. Nikola Jogo behind that pick and roll, and instead of shooting that three, and he can make that shot, he sees Trevion Williams closing out. He drives him wisely and gets to the foul line.
So Jogo goes to the line for the first time this year, knocks down the first free throw. He's been dealing with an ankle sprain that he suffered against Michigan State in their opening game, but has come back and given them quality minutes. And for this Notre Dame team that has some guys stepping up this year, Mike Bray said Jogo is a really important part of what they want to do this year, just to give them minutes off the bench.
Well, he's big today too, because they're going to play small. You're going to see Nate Leszczewski a ton at the five, and Jogo's a big guard who can give you minutes at the four. He can make an open shot, and he's tough. He knows what's going on. They're going to need him today if they're going to win.
Inside to Zach Edey.
Boy, that looked like a Nerf hoop. I mean, that was crazy. That was a great pass, and Zach Edey keeps it high. But the way he caught that basketball and went straight up with it and dunked the ball, that was really impressive by the freshman.
Really just incredible how talented he is playing basketball for only 3 years as Jogo hits the triple.
That's 100% what Notre Dame has got to do. They've got to flip that matchup. Edey's going to guard Nikola Jogo, and Jogo's got to make him pay. Does just that. Gets a great look from the right wing.
There's Gillis on the wing. Stefanovic goes inside to the freshman Edey. Can't get that one to fall. Loose on the floor, and it comes out to Prentice Hub. And now a whistle and a foul.
Here's that play. See the pass right here. Mason Gillis sees it right over the top. Edey does a great job of sealing Nate Leszczewski, and look at the way he keeps that high. And at 7-4, you don't have a whole lot of space to go. You can pretty much go up there and dunk the ball almost from your tiptoes.
The amazing thing, too, about Edey is because he was a hockey player and a baseball player, when they were trying to teach him the fundamentals of being a big man, they said catching the ball was never an issue for him because as a former baseball player, he could already catch. You know, they didn't have to work on that fundamental. But the way that he's taken to the game, pretty impressive as Dane Goodwin hits the three.
A really good look. Great ball movement by Notre Dame right there. And maybe a little bit of overhelping by Brandon Newman. Dane Goodwin has been on fire the last three games.
Edey sets the screen. Hunter the drive. Newman open for three. Hello, Newman.
The Seinfeld reference I see. The corner three, though, I am not a big proponent of helping out of the corner. I just think when you do that, there's no helping you. And we've seen that from both sides today. You help out of the corner. The corner three, one of the highest percentage shots in all of basketball. Here you're going to see it. Dane Goodwin gets really, really in on that help defense, and it's a horse shot. That is a wide open look. Brandon Newman going to make you pay.
Newman picked up the foul as well, and now an offensive foul against Ryan.
I think they're going to get Cormac Ryan for the Reggie Miller leg kick, and how appropriate here in Indianapolis at Bankers Life.
Second foul against Cormac Ryan.
There's that leg kick, and Brian O'Connell on the call.
Wheeler goes inside Edey.
Boy, you can hear Matt Painter. He is not pleased that Brandon Newman. I'm just going to let Matt Painter tell you. He is very vocal right now. Zach Edey had terrific post position. Brandon Newman doesn't throw it to him, and really Brandon Newman put him in a tough spot right there. That 3 seconds is on Brandon Newman.
So a turnover by Purdue, and now Notre Dame down by 9. Trying to cut at this deficit. Oh, Goodwin finding Jogo, kicks it out. Hub from the baseline, jumper won't fall. Wheeler there to Corelli. Hunter on the run. No.
Juwan Durham really did a great job of altering that shot, going straight up and starting the break.
And Goodwin to miss on the three. Frenetic pace the last three possessions. Now Stefanovic trying to get inside, and a whistle against Notre Dame. Trey Wirtz picking up his first personal. Purdue has made five of its last seven field goal attempts as they try to push the lead back to double digits. Wheeler inside, Edie again. Could not finish the dunk, but a foul call.
It's such a good play design by Purdue because Notre Dame's defense is so concerned about Sasha Stefanovic coming back off this pin down. And instead of doing that, he sets a back screen. Boy, if you're going to guard that, you've really got to communicate and talk your big through that. Really, Juwan Durham had no chance or no choice except to foul.
So now Edie at the free throw line. And the first one, good. Well, tomorrow we'll have the exclusive reveal of the college football playoff matchups in the Rose Bowl, the All-State Sugar Bowl to be played on New Year's Day. Reese and the guys will also unveil the New Year's Six bowl games and have the final top 25 rankings in this four-hour special. It all starts noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific, after Sunday NFL Countdown on ESPN and the ESPN app. The college football playoff selection show is presented by AT&T 5G.
Northwestern and Ohio State doing battle right down the road, and Northwestern trying to pull the upset of the century on the Buckeyes.
They sure are, and they were winning last I checked. There's a foul coming up against Edie as Wirtz gets in there for the bucket. So Trey Wirtz doing a nice job here in this first half. Gets the start for Notre Dame. Now has 9 points to match what he was able to do against Duke on Wednesday night.
Mike Bray was really high on Trey Wirtz, and he talked about how he's Prentice Hub's roommate. Maybe that can kind of rub off on him. Notre Dame going 1-3-1, and that might be the only possession they do that. That was a wide open look. Just too easy if you're Notre Dame. You give Sasha Stefanovic that type of look, he's going to make you pay.
And now Stefanovic will be whistled for the foul, his first. Stefanovic knocks down that three, and Robbie, it feels like every time Notre Dame tries to push it a little bit closer, Purdue comes back, hits a three.
This has been a game of runs on both sides, and we've seen Notre Dame have 2 and 3 minutes of really good offense, and then it flips back to Purdue. Again, we said this early, it's just gonna be so interesting. Right now, Notre Dame has their big lineup out there. I'm not sure you can go small. I know they want to offensively, but the bigs of Purdue, whether it's Trevion Williams or Zach Edey, they make it so tough on you. They're going to pound you inside. They're going to get on the offensive glass. And right now, that's why you see Juwan Durham and Nate Leshefsky out there together.
One team that Purdue has struggled with in the state of Indiana in recent years has been Notre Dame. Matt Painter just 1-3 against the Fighting Irish as the head coach of Purdue, despite so much winning and success in West Lafayette. And Stefanovic again from deep.
Trey Wirtz is learning the hard way right here. You cannot get disconnected from Sasha Stefanovic. If he's coming off a pin down, you have got to stay tight and stay on his backside. You get disconnected, you see right there, Stefanovic knocking down the triple.
Hub with the lead pass, works. Durham now 8 to shoot. Hub for three. Too strong in the rebound, Wheeler.
Prentice Hub comes into today as the second leading scorer in the ACC. He has 0 points, 0 for 5 from the field. He's got to keep being aggressive. Notre Dame needs him to score the ball.
Newman the miss. Edie the second chance is fouled. Brings us to another timeout on the floor. Edie will be at the free throw line where the Boilermakers have a 12-point lead in Indianapolis Crossroads Classic. All right, thank you, guys. And so far, Zach Edie showing those fundamentals here early, and he'll go to the free throw line. Edie so far today, 8 points for the Boilermakers, and another seven-footer for Purdue. For nine straight years, Robbie, Purdue has had a seven-foot player on the roster. It's become something that Matt Painter has been doing year after year.
Well, I know Juwan Johnson is asking, where were these guys when he was playing? They did not exist, that's for sure. But Purdue has almost become synonymous, and they have become synonymous with developing big men. And when you look at from Juwan Johnson to A.J. Hammonds to Caleb Swanigan, it's just great big after great big after great big. And Isaac Haas, another of the really big bigs that Purdue has had. But Brandon Brantley does a great job, and before him, Greg Gary did a great job, Paul Lusk. They've had terrific coaches who have been able to develop these bigs and turn them into pros.
There's Wirtz for three. That one will not go. Rebound to Wheeler.
Well, Notre Dame is getting some wide open looks on the perimeter, and they haven't shot it necessarily bad. They're at 35%, but man, if you're gonna give up the size on this end, you've gotta make shots on the other one.
Jaden Ivey comes through with that shot for Purdue. Now a 15-point lead for the Boilermakers. They're on a 6-0 run. Krzyzewski kicks to Wirtz, a three ball, good.
It's a great drive by Nate Krzyzewski. He has to understand if Zach Edey's gonna guard him, if the shot's not there initially, drive him right to the paint. That's what he did there, and he got that great look for Trey Wirtz.
Now they go inside, Edie over Krzyzewski, can't make it, and a foul as Edie went in to try to grab his own rebound.
Here's that dribble drive, and Krzyzewski being really aggressive. You have to help, because it's a blow by. Trey Wirtz getting it done from three. But then on the other end here, Krzyzewski did a terrific job defensively. Pushed Zach Edie off the block, made him score over the top of him, and then blocked him out. So on both ends, you get a great drive on the offensive end, terrific defense on the defensive end, and now Krzyzewski earns a trip to the foul line.
Yeah, the first one good for Nate Krzyzewski. So far today, just 4 points for Nate, but came into this one averaging just under 15 points and 9 rebounds a game. Third in the ACC in rebounding thus far this season. And connects on both. So back to a 10-point game. Just over 2 minutes left in the first half of this Crossroads Classic game from Baker's Life Fieldhouse in Indianapolis. And now this one's going the other way. Foul offensively against Purdue. That'll go on Aaron Wheeler away from the ball. So Goodwin will inbound after a couple of substitutions. Mason Gillis, a redshirt freshman, back on the floor for the Boilermakers as Edie gets a rest. What does Notre Dame have to do to get this game within maybe five at halftime?
They've got to start making shots. They've gotten great looks. And funny now that we're looking on the floor and Purdue has now gone small. We've gone from almost 1990s NBA type size for Purdue on the floor to now you've got four guards and a forward.
Where's the big dog when you need him? Krzyzewski inside off a nice feed for the bucket.
What a great cut by Nate Krzyzewski. He has had a terrific last 3 or 4 minutes and starting to get it going on both ends. Matt Painter wisely gonna take a timeout. And here once again, Notre Dame creeping back into this game. They found a way to cut this to 8. They are moving off the basketball, and Trey Wirtz with the drive. The help comes over. Krzyzewski makes himself available, and a big time find. Wirtz on the delivery, Krzyzewski with the layup.
So it's a 7-0 run for Notre Dame over the last 1:02. They've got themselves back within 8. Tomorrow, this should be a great top 20 Big Ten battle. Number 13, Illinois, squares off against number 19, Rutgers at the rack. First time the Scarlet Knights have started a season with five double-digit wins since the 34-35 campaign, won Eastern, noon Central, ESPN2, and on the ESPN app. Mike Bray's club was down 15. They score seven straight, now back within 10. Seeing if they can make this a one or two possession game in a first half that's largely been dominated by the Boilermakers.
Well, even more impressive with Notre Dame's comeback is that Prentice Hubb still has not scored.
Yeah. Averaging almost 20 a game and nothing in the first half today. Ivy for three, but an offensive foul away from the ball. And that'll be on Edey. Three on Zach Edey. And so that's a significant foul here with 1:19 to go in the half, and he'll come off the court, go to the bench.
Oh, and they're going to get Zach Edey for really leading with that elbow. I think Sean Farnham made a really good point where his elbows are so high that they're at face level for a lot of defenders.
Yeah.
And he went to post up there and absolutely smoked the defender in the face.
How do you combat that, though? Do you have him just play with his hands high more often?
I think a lot of the bigs, like an Isaac Haas, AJ, and not so much, more so, mostly Isaac, he really dealt with this, where you're posting at a level and you're taught to get your arms really up to post up. And because of his size, it's hard. I mean, I don't know what you teach him, because you see, it's not like he's in an unnatural position right here. He's like most post players, but man, he smokes Nate Leszczewski. It's definitely a foul.
Yeah, elbow up and Leszczewski goes down, who's 6'10", by the way.
No, he's by no means small.
Yeah.
But compared to 7'4", you know, it's just a different animal.
Right, Edey is towering over literally everyone on the court. So the officials reviewing this right now with 1:19 remaining here in the first half in Indianapolis.
I think with a lot of big guys too, you'll see, especially in basketball, they're not always super aware of what their body is doing. You know, there's sometimes where they, from a coordination standpoint, they haven't always put it totally together. And with that, I don't think that's malicious. I just think Zach Edey's been taught, get my elbows out, post up, this is how it's done. And, you know, Leszczewski just runs right into his elbow.
Yeah, they're taking another look here, I think, to see if they wanted to tack something on to the personal foul. But I'm with you, I don't think it was malicious. Just think he's a tall dude and his arms were up. Maybe this, though, will slow down some of the momentum, because Notre Dame, you know, gets this back within eight. And it was 15 before. Notre Dame was starting to build some of the momentum, so maybe in a small way, it slows things down and Purdue can regroup. Notre Dame coming off at loss Wednesday against Duke. 10-point defeat prior to that. Beat Kentucky on the road. So talk about a tough schedule over the course of a week. Kentucky, Duke, and now Purdue here today in the Crossroads Classic before they go exclusively back to playing games in the ACC. Purdue coming off a tough week as well. They beat Ohio State on Wednesday to open up Big Ten play. And they beat Indiana State last weekend. So now it looks like there's going to be a flagrant one foul called. What do you think?
I disagree. I know it's a contact to the head, but to me, there's really no malicious intent behind that play.
So this is a huge flagrant foul, because now Notre Dame will get opportunities at the free throw line and the basketball, so they can really cut into this deficit. Leszczewski at the line. So the junior knocks down the first. And And this could be a turning point for Notre Dame, adding to their 8-0 run. Now 9, and they'll have the ball. A good one to inbound for the Fighting Irish. Hub, the good one on the wing. Got Wheeler in the air, takes the three, can't get it to fall.
Well, that's another great look. And Dane Goodwin wisely with the head fake, steps aside. Aaron Wheeler flies by, and they have had good looks from three this afternoon.
And now Hunter for three. Too short, got the long rebound, and Purdue will keep. 20-second difference between the shot and the game clock here. Newman, too strong this time. Mucheski grabs the rebound. Shot clock is off. With a three, Notre Dame can make it a one-possession game. Going to the break. Here is Wirtz with 5 seconds into the paint, and a foul on the floor. 4.3 to go here in the first half.
Mike Bray told us he thought that Trey Wirtz could be a creator just like Prentice Hub, and he showed it right there. That was a tight handle. That was an explosive dribble drive. Trey Wirtz, so interesting, because you think about a guy that says, hey, I'm sitting out this year. I've got to work hard in practice. I've got to make sure I do what I'm supposed to do to get the team ready to play. And all of a sudden, the NCAA comes in and says, hey, everybody's eligible. And now you're playing against Duke.
Yeah.
it's a whirlwind tour. But this is a kid that started 63 games at Santa Clara. And he averaged 11 points, almost 4 assists a game. Was really efficient. Mike Bray is a big fan of what Trey Wirtz does.
And he's got 15 first half points as Purdue unable to get a shot up at the end of the half. And Notre Dame down by 5 at halftime, a 10-0 run over the last 2.5 minutes to take us to the break. Halftime in Indy, we go to Dallin Cuff, Sean Farnham, John Crispin for the E-Trade Halftime Report. Getting set for the second half of this Crossroads Classic game here at Bankers Life Fieldhouse in Indianapolis alongside Robbie Hummel. I'm Jordan Burfield. Thanks so much for joining us. Purdue with a 5-point lead as we get set for the second half. And in the first half, Zach Edey making an impact yet again.
Yes, he was. Travion Williams only plays 8 minutes because of foul trouble, and Purdue really looked to the big fella to throw it inside to him. Showed the ability to catch lobs. He can post up. Really got great position on a lot of plays in the first half. But for Notre Dame, Trey Wirtz has been a huge story. And on a day where Prentice Hub has gone scoreless in the first half, he gives you 15 points, 4 assists, showing off the ability to make plays and really get in the paint. I've been really impressed with Trey Wirtz. Only found out he was even playing this season within the last week. So I'd say it's been quite a week for him. And this is by far his best game for Notre Dame thus far in his career.
Purdue shot the ball a lot better in the first half, but Notre Dame able to stay in it. There was the flagrant foul called against Zach Edey late in that first half, which allowed Notre Dame to finish the half on an 11-0 run. And now they find themselves down by 5 as we start the second half. But Eric Hunter trying to change that. The steal, and cannot finish underneath. Second chance opportunity, but Gillis there to clean it up.
A great effort by Mason Gillis to stay in that play and not assume that Eric Hunter is going to convert on that layup. Boy, Cormac Ryan, that's just a pass you cannot throw. He has really struggled at times, especially the last two games. It's almost like he's just overthinking things. And Mike Bray even told us last night, he said, look, I told Cormac, you're going to play 30 minutes. You have to play 30 minutes. We only have really 7 guys in our rotation. So just go out there, shoot when you're open, move it if you're not. To me, it really looks like Cormac Ryan is just overthinking the game right now.
Well, you mentioned, too, the rotation for this Notre Dame team, Robbie. It's a great point because that's when you were mentioning Trey Wirtz, having him available, not even just the impact that he's made with 15 points, but having him available now gives Notre Dame nine guys that they could go to.
Well, they needed to add depth. And boy, Cormac Ryan's afternoon has been really tough. That was almost like he forced that shot trying to make up for the turnover.
Now on the move inside, the bucket good from Newman.
Brandon Newman, I knew he could score coming out of high school, but the other things have been what's really impressed me, that the ability to put it on the floor defensively.
Wirtz with a nice feed to Leshefsky.
Man, Leshefsky just slipped right out of that ball screen. The help side defense for Purdue totally asleep, and Notre Dame steals an easy bucket.
Newman goes inside. Travion Williams, just eight first half minutes. The hook shot over Leshefsky, and it won't fall. Up on the run, lost the handle. Stefanovic saves it to Hunter.
Great effort by Eric Hunter, just tipping that ball away from Prentice Hub, making a play.
And now the kick out, Stefanovic for three. Rebounded underneath Williams to an open Hunter. And misses that three. Third try, and Gillis converts.
Purdue starting to really impose their will on the offensive glass, whether it's Travion Williams or Mason Gillis. Purdue is flying around, sending multiple guys to the offensive glass.
And now a foul against Newman. He tried to get positioning underneath against Goodwin. Back to a 9-point lead for the Boilermakers, who clearly, Robbie, have come out with energy to start the second half. Inbound goes to Goodwin, baseline jumper. And both Purdue players went for it. I think Gillis will be credited for that rebound.
That's the third time we've seen Notre Dame this afternoon run that same under out of bounds play. They've got a great look off of it every time. Just a simple pin down. And to me, that's been the biggest story of the afternoon is outside of Trey Wirtz, Notre Dame just hasn't made open shots.
Ooh. Williams can't finish the dunk. Hub almost lost the handle, the save to Goodwin. Stops on the baseline, jumper won't fall. Williams tips it to Hunter. And now a whistle and a foul away from the ball. That'll go against Jogo. Notre Dame had it to five, four straight points for Purdue. Boilermakers 15-2 in their last 17 games against teams in the state of Indiana since the 16-17 season. The losses have been to Notre Dame and Butler in this Crossroads Classic. For whatever reason, Boilers have struggled playing in this event. They've played well so far today. There is Goodwin now on the wing. Down low, Durham. Back out and a wide open Goodwin for three. Dane Goodwin now with 9 points this afternoon.
Boy, if you're going to post trap from the strong side, which is exactly what Brandon Newman does there, off of Dane Goodwin, you better be rotating. There's nobody in Purdue's defense right there that's coming into the shooter, and Dane Goodwin gets a great look from the perimeter.
And now they go to the block for Williams.
You got one.
Against a double. And he lost the handle. Good defense from Notre Dame, and now they throw it away right back to Purdue. A lot of legends have played basketball in the great state of Indiana. We will show you some of those that have ties to these schools when we come back to Bankers Life Fieldhouse. Here at Bankers Life Fieldhouse in Indianapolis, Indiana, where all roads lead here for this Crossroads Classic, where four of the storied programs in the state of Indiana meeting for this Crossroads Classic event. And you can see there's been so many legends that have coached or played in this state. And look at Tony Hinkle, coached at Butler for 41 seasons. The arena, of course, named after him on Butler's campus. Bob Knight needs no introduction in this state. The Big O won state titles in high school here. John Wooden, of course, and how could you not talk Larry Bird? He's synonymous with Indiana basketball.
Players, coaches, it does not matter. I would put Indiana against any other state in this country and say, let's see what you got basketball-wise. And I'm pretty confident now. I'm biased. I'm from Valparaiso, but it's a great state to grow up in. You have great coaches, good players. It's special when you get to play in Indiana high school basketball here. It's a different deal. It's a special deal for these kids.
When you're talking about growing up and playing basketball, that's everywhere in this state. Just the passion for the game is really something to see. And there's Jogo knocking down a three, and certainly Notre Dame needed that. Now they're back within three.
That ball is moving for Notre Dame. You get a simple ball screen, and then it's a swing action right to the weak Scott side. Nicola Jogo letting it fly. You said it earlier, has played injured this season, hurt his ankle against Michigan State, played a little sore against Kentucky, but the ball movement, a beautiful thing to see. Mike Bray's ball club has really hung in this afternoon, and now they find themselves within one possession of Purdue.
They hung around well, there's no doubt. Now Edie setting the screen for an open Hunter. Can't get that jumper to go. Looks like Wheeler stepped on the line. It'll be Notre Dame basketball.
But Juwan Durham is really fighting Zach Edie on the block, and when that shot goes up, you have got to find the 7-4 center's body. It's 100% what Juwan Durham did, and Notre Dame rewarded for that effort.
Juwan Durham, the graduate senior, second best block average in Notre Dame basketball history.
I have to say, Jordan, if you had told me Prentice Hubb had 0 points, I'd say, how much is Notre Dame down by?
Right.
He has been such a big part of their scoring. Trey Wirtz has really picked up the slack, and Purdue wants to let Nicola Jogo shoot. Jogo making the Boilers pay.
And this game is tied at 53. The last tie was when it was 9-9, 17-13 to go back in the first half. So Notre Dame has climbed all the way back in it. They're on a 9-0 run. Purdue trying to get on the board. They haven't scored in almost 3.5 minutes. They change it right there with Hunter.
Just a huge shot by Eric Hunter, and Cormac Ryan countering screens on that play. You have got to be a guy that gets through these pin downs. Eric Hunter had all the time in the world right there.
Jogo, another three try. That one won't go.
That was a heat check from Nicola Jogo, and sure with good reason.
Stefanovic lost his footing, but able to keep. Hunter against Jogo. Now Purdue will reset. 10 to shoot. Stefanovic inside the free throw line. And a foul is called.
A late call from Brooks Wells right there. Sasha Stefanovic trying to get to his pull-up. I think They're going to get Prentice Hub for sliding underneath him when he landed. There's that little push, and there is contact as he goes up, so a good call. As a shooter, that's your worst nightmare. You go up in a game, you get kind of knocked on your arm, you shoot an air ball, and if they don't call it, you're looking at the ref like, dude, there's no way that's not a foul. Like, you have got to call that. And as a shooter, you take pride, right? Like, shooting an air ball is embarrassing. I think anybody's been there that's played the game, but a good job by Brooks Wells coming in and making that call, even if it was late.
I would know something about the air ball.
Oh, you're experienced in that regard.
But it's in a pickup game, not a big deal, right?
Not on national television.
Exactly. Hunter in the corner. There's Gillis. A three and rattles through.
That is 100% the product of Trevion Williams demanding so much attention on the block. Nikola Jogo has got to help inside, and because of that, you're getting great looks. Mason Gillis continues to shoot the ball at a super high level.
And a season high 10 points now for Gillis, the redshirt freshman. There's Wirtz. Cycle around, 2 seconds to shoot, but a travel by Jogo on his way in.
Much better defense and the ability to rotate there off of that pick and roll is so important. You're going to see Trevion Williams is really showing attention to Trey Wirtz. Mason Gillis is ready to fire right to Nate Leszewski. You force that extra pass, you keep the defense in the play, and Nikola Jogo, who wants to shoot that with the way he shot today, puts it on the floor, ends up traveling.
Oh, after the run that tied the game for Notre Dame, it's a 7-0 run for Purdue. Trying to add to it here. Isaiah Thompson back into the game. Nice feed underneath, and Sasha Stefanovic lays it in.
There's Trevion Williams showing off his big-time passing ability. You get a great cut from Stefanovic going right to the basket. Trevion Williams, you get open for him, he's going to find you.
He's an impressive passer for a big man.
Has a great feel for the game. His ability to pass. Notre Dame just refusing to go away.
And finally, Cormac Ryan connects on to three. And it brings us to the floor. But Purdue with the lead, but Notre Dame hanging around despite some nifty passing. How about that? Trevion Williams finding Stefanovic. Well, tomorrow this should be a great top 20 Big Ten battle, number 13. Illinois squares off against number 19 Rutgers at the rack. The first time the Scarlet Knights have started a season with 5 double-digit wins since 34-35. 1 Eastern, noon Central, EF2, and on the app. Right now, Purdue with a 6-point advantage on Notre Dame with 0-1 to go here in half number 2 at the Crossroads Classic. Is Matt Painter looking? 342 wins with the Boilermakers program in year number 16. Jaden Ivey inside for Trevion Williams.
What a pass by Jaden Ivey. The defender had never turned his head as he got back and recovered to Trevion Williams, and Jaden Ivey threw it right by his ear. Go,
Prentice Hub, nifty pass. Ryan catches the three ball. Too strong, but gets the long rebound. Hey, Wirtz will try for three. That won't go. And Gillis the rebound.
Two really, really high quality looks for Notre Dame. They have shot it pretty well today at 41% from three, but you think about how many open ones they've had, have not been able to convert.
They've hit 12 threes today, which is a cross classic record. Now I say it, Thompson, and that won't go. Olszewski grabs the rebound.
I'm surprised that 12 is only the record for as good of shooters as there are in this state.
I know.
These four teams, you'd think it'd be more like 16.
Goodwin the three, no. And now a foul underneath. Ivy will be called for it. So many connections when these teams get together in this state. Somebody Robbie knows pretty well. We're going to talk about him when we come back.
To show up the show, do you need power or this optimum power? Because Duracell Optimum makes this RC truck even faster than copper.
You know what I think? I think you owe us $48.50. Wild thing.
If you ride, you get it. Geico, 15 minutes could save you 15% or more.
Some can give to you five bread sticks for my triple treat. Three layers deep, 10 cent a bite, and a pizza plus another pizza.
Now that's festive.
The triple treat box only from knowing our pizza's the hut.
So this is how you make a cat, a dog. It's cool.
It's more than just a gift. Ask Pro Shops and Cabela's. You'll find great gear that give memories that last forever. Check out our huge deals on gifts for the whole family. Shop in our stores or online.
This year we decided to host for the holidays.
It was a tight squeeze.
Sorry.
Turns out to cook a whole dinner, you need a whole kitchen. Then we found out with Rocket Mortgage, looking at loan options for our next kitchen was easy.
I'm just kidding.
I think her family really enjoyed it.
Mm-hmm. Here we go. When you're ready for a home that's fit for the holidays and your budget, Rocket can.
I did some early shopping this year. One for you, one for me.
I love it. I got us a little something too.
Yeah?
Yep. One for you, and one for me.
I love it.
Oh, actually, that was supposed to be for me.
I love it.
I like that.
It's the GMC season to upgrade. Now everyone can get GM employee pricing on most GMC models. Use it to get over $6,200 total value on this 2021 Acadia Denali, our professional grade GMC.
So many connections between these schools, and you see Scott Martin, the assistant coach at Notre Dame, your former teammate Robbie Hummel at Purdue.
I think I met Scott on the soccer field as second graders, and we played basketball really from third or fourth grade all the way to our freshman years at Purdue. And there you see us playing at the YMCA. My dad, the fashion icon, watching too much Tool Time. But we ball together, and as good of a player as Scott Martin was, and he was a great player, he's an even better guy. And I'm so happy and proud of him for going back to his alma mater, 1 year old, and now being an assistant coach. Just phenomenal.
That's great stuff. So that team you guys were on together had to have been pretty good, huh?
I'm assuming we with the YMCA. I think we had some serious talent there.
Well, I think it was your dad coaching that really steered the ship.
The plaid shirt, too. Yeah, that was fantastic.
Underneath, there's Hunter, and splashes through the jumper. Eric Hunter puts in this afternoon's game.
He just plays with such poise. And getting him back was so big for Purdue. He has been and on the offensive end to get a bucket. It's been Eric Hunter.
There's Durham. Measures that one against Williams and shot it way too long. Hunter into the paint. Stops and kicks. Open three. Good for Isaiah Thompson.
Look who again. Eric Hunter making that play happen. And coming into the day, Isaiah Thompson was 0 for his last 7 from the field. Hadn't scored in 3 games.
And a very much needed bucket for Trey Wirtz. It's a 16-5 run for Purdue over the last 5 minutes.
And Matt Painter was furious with the defensive effort there. Trey Wirtz waltzed in. Gets a wide open layup. And now Notre Dame going to try some 2-3 zone. Trying to show a different look to Purdue here.
And Williams spinning into the paint, draws the foul.
Well, Eric Hunter has been really good today, especially in pick and roll. And you see how that defense, it's showing Travion Williams a ton of love on the backside of that play. Isaiah Thompson is wide open. But Eric Hunter, man, there wasn't much air under that pass. That was a rocket right to the shooting pocket, a big time look.
And Travion Williams at the line misses the first. But Purdue has looked very impressive again today. Obviously, lots of time to play in this game, 9:09 to go. Notre Dame has crept back in it. At one point, they tied the game, but again, the Boilermakers asserting themselves and doing it the way that they do best, right? Getting into the paint, getting easy buckets.
Every time Notre Dame has made a run, I think Purdue has done a nice job of not settling for jump shots, whether it's throw it inside, get dribble penetration, and off that penetration, if the three is there, they've taken it. But they've had an answer for Mike Bray's ball club at every step of this game.
Shooting 54% in the game today. Ryan almost had that one taken by Ivy. Prentice Hub, 3 seconds to shoot. They kick out Ryan, end of the shot clock, hits the three.
What a pass. Prentice Hub having an understanding that with the shot clock going down, he's got enough time. Again, that help side defense is in. You find your shooter on the weak side. Cormac Ryan gets it done on that play.
Now back to an 8-point game. Hunter tries to answer, misses the three. Leshefsky crashes in for the rebound.
They were daring him to shoot it, weren't they? They were in that 2-3 zone. They were letting him shoot.
And now Leshefsky misses that three. Ivy the rebound. Ivy on the run to the basket, knocked out of bounds by Hub.
Well, really nice play by Prentice Hub, because Juwan Durham never saw the basketball. He was trying to recover on that play, and I'm sure Jordan Cornette will be thrilled. That block will be attributed to Prentice Hub, not Juwan Durham. Your record is safe
for now, Jordan. All right, thank you, guys. 69-61, Purdue the lead as we take a look at the college basketball headlines today. And number five, Kansas, just escaped with that win at Texas Tech a couple of nights ago. St. Louis now 6-0 after their win over NC State. BYU knocking off a ranked opponent in San Diego State. How about Gonzaga today, Robbie? 99 points against Iowa, and they get the win.
Sending a message. I think, to me, Gonzaga and Baylor are the two best teams I've seen all year. And Iowa today was trying to show that maybe they should be in that group. And I think the big question remains with Iowa, can they guard at a high enough level to be somebody that can beat a team like a Gonzaga or a Baylor?
Certainly Gonzaga with an impressive victory today. Iowa, so much offensive firepower. But 99-88 win. Durham got the block on one end and now a foul on the other end. Mason Gillis picks up the foul. And Notre Dame inbounds with under 8 minutes to go here at Bankers Life Fieldhouse. Prentice Hub on the elbow, passes up the shot. Still has not scored today. Came into today averaging over 19 points per contest. Hub will take a three from the top of the key. That won't go, and a foul underneath.
0-7, that is shocking. It's gonna be interesting to see down the stretch as Notre Dame needs to make up ground, this 8-point lead. He's been their guy. End of the game, Prentice Hub has been the guy that they've gone to. They put him in pick and roll and they just say, hey, Prentice, make plays. But it's hard to do when your confidence is waning and you're 0-7 on the day. We're gonna see just exactly how confident Prentice Hub really is. It takes an ultra confident guy to feel that way when you're having an afternoon like this.
Stefanovic for three from the wing. And Sasha's had a big day. He's got 18 points now.
Against that 2-3 zone, just a little bit of ball movement. Sasha Stefanovic gets a fantastic look.
Five threes today for Stefanovic. Now Leshefsky tries to answer. Can't hit the three. Goodwin the rebound. Leaves off Leshefsky.
That's going to infuriate Matt Painter. Just no blockouts on that play. Multiple offensive rebounds, and eventually, even with Notre Dame getting great looks, they finally find one at the rim for Nate Leshefsky.
Hunter stops in the lane, kick out Newman. Three ball is good. Brandon Newman now with eight. Again, every time Notre Dame seems to close the gap, Purdue comes back with something like that. Ryan,
great move.
Good pass to Durham, and he's fouled.
I will say one of the positives of COVID has been we've been able to hear the coaches, and right there Matt Painter is saying, what are you doing? A great move by Cormac Ryan, going behind his back, getting by Sasha Stefanovic, then dropping it off for Juwan Durham.
Third personal foul against Mason Gillis, the freshman. Well, tomorrow we'll have the exclusive reveal of the college football playoff matchups in the Rose Bowl, the All-State Sugar Bowl to be played on New Year's Day. Reese and the guys will also unveil the New Year's Six Bowl games and have the final top 25 rankings in this four-hour special. It all starts noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific, after Sunday NFL Countdown on ESPN and the ESPN app. The College Football Playoff Selection Show is presented by AT&T 5G. Ten-point lead for Purdue with under 6 minutes left now. Here's Newman again for three. Off target, the rebound to Wheeler. Newman spins in the lane, lost the handle, out of bounds. Purdue will keep.
Well, Trey Wirtz really moved his feet right there. Brandon Newman made two or three moves, ends up going in. Great hands to knock that away on a really tough drive.
Hunter will inbound. 8 seconds to shoot now for Purdue. Hunter around the screen from Edie, hits the three.
Well, a big time crossover dribble there. Eric Hunter left Cormac Ryan in the dust. Gets free, shot clock going down, and a big time move, a big time shot by Eric Hunter.
16 for Eric Hunter in this game. Wirtz drives on the Twin Towers Pretty. And puts it high off glass.
That was a beautiful finish. Trey Wirtz has been really good for Notre Dame today and kept it in his right hand, floated it high off the backboard.
Nice looking move indeed for Trey Wirtz, and Eric Hunter has been a big impact player today for Purdue, Robbie. He's had a big game.
Well, Eric Hunter, 16 points on the day, 6 of 14 from the field, 4 of 7 from 3, and especially in the second half, whenever it's felt like Purdue has needed something, he's been the guy to give it to him. Whether it's scoring, finding the guy who's open on the perimeter, getting to his pull-up, Eric Hunter has been fantastic today at Bankers Life Fieldhouse.
Eric Hunter, the junior right from Indianapolis. He had a compression fracture of his tibia in early November, so they weren't really sure how he was going to be coming back from that. But his comeback looks healthy today. The 16 points, it's hit four threes. And Purdue showing that they can mix and match. They've got good depth. And the junior impressing today after a 15-point effort against Ohio State on Wednesday.
I think you also got to talk about his assist numbers.
Yeah.
He's got 7 assists. He has found guys whenever he's needed to. Whenever he's been put in pick and roll, he's made the right play. It feels like almost every time.
The four threes today tying a career high for Hunter. So now with 5:15 left, and Purdue with an 11-point lead. Robbie, we've said it a few times today. Yes, at one point, Notre Dame had tied this game at 53, but it seems like every time they get close, Purdue pulls away. If you're Mike Bray, what do you think he said to his team right now?
I think he told Prentice Hub, we need you to be the guy. We need you to go out here, and whether it's makes a play for somebody else or get yourself going, if they're going to win, he's going to have to be the guy that carries them to that. He has got to be aggressive, and I think if you're Prentice Hub, you can't leave any bullets in the chamber here. You have got to shoot through this.
0 for 7 in today's game, 0 for 4 from 3. Hub does have 5 points and 3 assists in this one.
And I say that because he's, outside of probably Trey Wirtz and maybe Dane Goodwin, he's one of the guys who can go and get his own shot.
Trevion Williams with a nice hook, and he's got 10.
He's just too big for Nate Leshefsky. He got right to his spot, got right what he wanted in the right jump hook. And when he's simple and he does what he does well, he's incredibly effective.
Leshefsky tries to drive by Williams, but can't finish. And the Boilers will set it up. Wheeler goes back to Williams. 10 to shoot. Backs him down, spins in the lane, puts it off glass.
It must be nice to have hands like that. Well, he palms the ball like very few can. But he is in total control of what he's doing. Felt the defender and rolled back to that left side.
And then gets the steal from Leshefsky. Trevion Williams, the preseason All Big Ten selection, and you can see why. Coming up. Last weekend had a 30.11 rebound effort against Indiana State. He's one of 3 players in the country that have a 30-11 game this year. Wheeler for 3, no, and there's Williams again for the rebound.
And this is the guy who had 38-20 against John Teske at Michigan last season.
Yep.
He's a good player. It's not like he got space jammed, like he didn't have his power stolen. It was a matter of time for him to start playing better.
Wheeler, another miss from 3. Hub outside Wirtz, 3 ball is good. 22 in the game now for Trey Wirtz. But still a 12-point lead for Purdue as we trickle under 3 minutes to go here at Bankers Life Fieldhouse. Here's Wheeler. 3 is too strong, comes out to Hub. Wirtz is blocked by Newman.
Travion Williams starting to impose his will on the Notre Dame Fighting Irish, getting to the right jump hook, going back to the fadeaway. Travion Williams showing up and showing out.
All right, thank you guys. And yeah, I mean, Kentucky 1-5, that doesn't even compute.
No, I mean, I think when you look at what their program has been, and especially with the expectations of this season for Kentucky, it's almost unfathomable. Now, with that being said, Cal has a totally new team, and you have to assume they're going to get better as they build some chemistry. But man, 1-5, whoa.
Trey Wirtz hits another three, and so he's got 25 points in this game today. He's hit 5 threes and has kept Notre Dame in it. They trail by 9. Robbie, we've been talking about it. You know, Prentice Hubb, no points, 0 for 7 from the field. He's such a talented player and such a good scorer. If he had a normal game today, then this game would probably be tied.
No, it's shocking to see him with 0. That is really surprising. Honestly, though, Trey Wirtz, I thought when Mike Bray told us last night that he can be like a Prentice Hubb, you're thinking, all right, well, you know, he's his coach. Of course he's going to say that. Right. He's shown it today, man. He's been really impressive in all facets.
Yeah, Bray spoke glowingly about him, and you can see why. What a feed underneath Hunter to Williams for the flush.
Boy, again, Eric Hunter setting the table. Travion Williams getting it done. It's a beautiful pick and roll.
Now Hub feeds it out. Cormac Ryan for three. That rims out. Gillis comes up with it as we trickle down.
Mason Gillis just does a lot of little things that help you win games, like getting a rebound like that. That's going to be Notre Dame basketball. And Gillis flies right over the top, and you're just stealing possessions. It's a winning play.
This Purdue team with a bunch of new young guys that have looked impressive so far today. Williams, one of the vets. Can't make that one, but there's Gillis again to grab it. And his bench is cheering for him. Possession arrow will keep it with Purdue. Nice job right there by Gillis underneath.
We're going to go back to that pick and roll, and look at the way Eric Hunter gets deep and draws Juwan Durham to him. Weak side help, non-existent. Cormac Ryan so concerned about Sasha Stefanovic getting to the top of the key that you let Travion Williams roll right to the basket and get a wide open dunk.
70 seconds left here at Bankers Life Fieldhouse. Good day of basketball. And Purdue trying to pick up a win over Notre Dame. And now Williams into the shot clock, misses that one, the rebound, Durham. Mike Bray, 4-1 against Purdue as the head coach of Notre Dame. But it looks like Matt Painter and his club is going to get the victory. As they have been more dominant in this game for longer stretches, but Trey Wirtz has been so important to Notre Dame's success. Now 26 points, I think, for the Fighting Irish, even though it doesn't look like they're going to have enough in this one. You have to feel positive about what this kid might be able to bring. And when Hub has a normal offensive output, which we assume he will have for most of the games this season, you just added a big weapon here. Notre Dame has got some pieces to be really good.
With Notre Dame's depth, it was such a concern. You're playing really 6 or 7 guys, and now you add a guy like Trey Wirtz who can score the ball at this type of level. He's got 27 today. You're totally right. You found something here, and Prentice Hub's not going to have. I'd be shocked if he goes scoreless again this season. You know, he's way too good a player to have 0 points.
Durham commits the foul. That's all Notre Dame can do here to try to stop the clock. And six fouls against Notre Dame. They're going to have to foul again to put Purdue on the free throw line to get possessions back. Stefanovic gets it in to Hunter. Still no foul. Finally, Hub gets Hunter on the arm. You look at this Boilermaker team, Robbie, and there's a lot to like here. They have a younger team because, you know, they lost some players from last season, of course, but when you look at the impact that Edey made in this game, you look at some of the role players like Hunter, who had a huge game today, Williams, another strong outing, and it looks like Matt Painter's team again is poised to be near the top of the Big Ten.
No, they're certainly a team that's growing and learning. I think youth is the term that you use there, where they certainly have a lot of young guys. But at the same time, you have a junior class who have played in a lot of Big Ten basketball games. They're going to have to be the ones that lead the way. And today, you know, Eric Hunter had a great game with 16. Sasha Stefanovic gives you 18. Trevion Williams, another complete game where he has played really well. The junior class is going to take them as far as they're going to go. And these young guys, I think, as they get more experience, they're going to grow into their roles. They're going to get more confident. And I think by the end of the year, you could have a really good Purdue basketball team.
Dane Goodwin, turnaround jumper, no. Rebound to Gillis and a foul on Ryan. The fourth foul against Cormac Ryan with 25 and a half seconds left. But the Boilermakers trying to pick up this victory. In for Notre Dame, Tony Sanders Jr. Came in unranked in the preseason for the first time since the 14-15 season. But they have the arrow pointing up for sure. And now Gillis at the free throw line trying to ice this thing away. Mason Gillis with 11. And the shot clock is off. We'll see what Notre Dame has this perhaps final possession here. Ryan, a three. That goes. Ryan with 14 today. But Purdue can now waste out the clock. The Boilermakers with an impressive game today. And they're going to pick up the victory here at the Crossroads Classic here in Indianapolis. 88-78, the final score. And Matt Painter picks up his second win ever against the Notre Dame Fighting Irish. So for Robbie Hummel, I'm Jordan Burnfield saying so long from Indianapolis. Coming up next, the best of This is SportsCenter Mascot Mayhem. Thanks so much for joining.